कृष्णा कीर्तन गान नर्तन पनौ प्रेमामृतम मनीधि धीराधीर जन प्रियौ प्रिय करौ निमचरौ पूजितौ श्री चैतन्य कृपा भरौ भुवि भुव भरा वहन्ता रखौ वन्दे रूप सनातन रघु जगौ श्री जीव गोपाल कौ कृष्णा कीर्तन गान नर्तन पनौ प्रेमामृतम बनिधि धीराधीर जन प्रिय प्रिय करौ निर्मसरौ पूजितौ नाना शास्त्र विचार नहीं सद्धर्म संस्थापक लोकानां हितकारिणौ त्रिभुवने मनौ शरण्याकनौ नाना शास्त्र विचार नहीं सद्धर्म संस्थापक लोकानां हितकारिणौ त्रिभुवने मनौ शरण्याकरौ राधा कृष्ण पदारविन्द भजनानन्दीन मत्वालिकौ वन्दे रूप सनातनौ रघुजुगौ श्रीजीव गोपालकौ कृष्ण कीर्तन गान नर्तन पनौ प्रेमामृतम बनिधि श्री चैतन्य कृपा भरौ भुवि भुव भरा वहन्तारकौ वन्दे रूप सनातनो रघु जगौ श्री जीव गोपालकौ श्री गौरांग गुणानुगणन विभौ सद्या समिधान्वितौ पापत्रापनिकन्तनौ तनुभितां गोविन्द गानामृतै श्री गौरांग गुणानुगणन विभौ सद्या समिधान्वितौ पापत्रापनिकीर्तनौ तनुभितां गोविन्ददानामृतं आनन्दाम्बुदिवर्धनै कनिपुणौ कैवल्यनिस्वारकौ वन्दे रूप सनातनौ रघुजुगौ श्रीदेव गोपालकौ कृष्ण कीर्तन गान नर्तन पदौ प्रेमामृतम बनिधि तत्पातु नमसे समन्नलपति शनि सदा तूक्ष्म भूत्वा दीन गणेशकौ करुणया कौपीन कंथाश्रितौ तत्पातु नमसे समन्नलपति शनि सदा तूक्ष्म भूत्वा दीन गणेशकौ करुणया कोपीनकण्ठाश्रितौ गोपीभावरसामृताभिलहरी कल्लोलमग्नोन्मुहो वन्दे रूपसनातनरघुजगं श्रीजीवगोपालकौ कृष्णकीर्तनकाननतनपरौ प्रेमामृताम्बनिधि कृष्णकीर्तनकाननतनपरौ प्रेमामृताम्बनिधि कोकिलहंसारसुगणकीर्णमयूराकुले नानारत्ननिबद्धमूलपिटप श्रीयुक्तवृन्दावने राधाकृष्णमहन्निसं प्रवजतौ जीवार्थदौ जौ बुदा वन्दे रूपसनातन रघुजगं श्रीजीवगोपालकं कृष्णकीर्तनगाननतनपरं प्रेमामृताम्बनिधि धीराधीरजनप्रियं प्रियकरं निमसरं पूजितं शङ्खापूर्वकनामगाननतिभिः कालावसानिकृतं निद्राहारविहारकादिविदितं चत्तन्तौ दीनौ च शङ्खापूर्वकनामगाननतिभिः कालावसानिकृतं निद्राहारविहारकादिविदितं चत्तन्तौ दीनौ च गोपीभावरसामृताभिलहरी कल्लोलमग्नोन्महो वन्दे रूपसनातनरघुजगं श्रीजीवगोपालकं कृष्णकीर्तनगाननतनपरं प्रेमामृताम्बनिधि कृष्णकीर्तनगाननतनपरं राधापुन्नतके कलिन्दतनयातिरे च वंशीवटे प्रेमन्माधवसादशेषदशया ग्रस्तौ प्रमत्तौ सदा राधापुन्नतके कलिन्दतनयातिरे च वंशीवटे प्रेमन्माधवसादशेषदशया ग्रस्तौ प्रमत्तौ सदा राधाकृष्णगुणस्मिते मधुरिमा नन्देन मोहितौ वन्दे रूपसनातनरघुजगं श्रीदेवगोपालकृष्णकीर्तनगाननतनपरं प्रेमामृताम्बनिधि
I'm Reed Collins. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. A hypnotic rhythmic chant of 16 words has replaced LSD and other drugs for some in New York's East Village. On 2nd Avenue and 1st Street is a storefront in which a Hindu Swami has set up shop. There, his American disciples are learning about Krishna consciousness.
We have all of the beautiful things and ugly things. We have duality. But the chant is to get us out of nature and into Krishna's superior universe, which is the spiritual universe. And this is what the chant is really intended to do. It's to take you off into eternity. I started chanting in July. I was still taking LSD at the time. But he was against LSD. He said, I told him, what do you think of my taking LSD for my spiritual realization, expanded consciousness? I was interested in staying high forever, as it were, maintaining an awareness of the universe that was flowing through me and past me at every second of my life. He says, that's not necessary. He said, your spiritual life is already here. He says, you don't need to take anything for your spiritual life. And I knew he was right. And he had that exalted state of consciousness. I sensed it. And I knew he didn't take anything. And I knew that I wanted this state of consciousness and that he could teach it to me.
Krishna consciousness is nothing but the moment-to-moment realization that nothing is yours. Neither anything you use in this world, or your body, or even your mind. Krishna is our divine father, the one Lord. Doesn't make any difference what you call him, Allah, Muhammad, or Buddha, or Jehovah, Christ. There's only one. Krishna is our father. All things are his, and we have happiness, true happiness, when we use all things for him.
I practice my Krishna consciousness by chanting when I work and on my way to work. And this is what we ask all good people, to try chanting. Try it when you wake up in the morning. Try it on your way to work on the subway. I know I chant every day on the way to work in the subway, and other people are kicking and shoving. I'm chanting, and I enjoy my subway rides.
All glory to the assembled devotees. All glory to the assembled.
And now we are going to go uptown to St. Mark's Place to do our kirtan and spread joy and peace to the people of New York. We invite all our friends to join us. Hare Krishna.
Hare Rama.
Wandering in the street, and some of the boys saw me, and gradually they came to me. And actually, I did not try anything for developing this institution. The boys did it. Yeah. They are all educated. They are not fools. Mr. Howard is MA. He does BA, and he's doctor at PhD, so they're all educated. So they're not fools that they're taking this blindly, you know. Most of my students, they were under the spell of this LSD, but they are given up everything. They're simply living on this chapati and some fruits, and that's all. They don't try, they don't eat meat, they don't want wine, they don't want cigarette, they don't want tea, coffee, nothing. And they're chanting Hare Krishna, they're following my instruction. So I'm getting good hope.
Swamiji's eating upstairs?
Yes. Meal is composed of rice and this soup which we call dal, and a combination of vegetables and the chapati which is made out of whole wheat. You see, it's all vegetable and grain. Sometimes some fruit, there's fruit in the dal. No meat. No animal product, just egg. This is because in the Gita, Krishna has told us what he wants us to eat, namely fresh fruits and grains, not animal products. And so we have a very delicious meal here. It's very cheap. It goes a long way. It's quite easy to prepare. And we have a lot of fun.
But essentially, these are foods that are prescribed according to orthodox Vaishnavite discipline. You know. So these foods are prescribed, but we don't necessarily prescribe them for everybody. The main thing is no meat, fish, and eggs.
No meat, fish, and eggs. Why not?
Well, because in the scriptures, it states that certain foods Krishna will accept. So we have to offer our food to Krishna. We have to offer the food that he'll accept. The food that he'll accept is stated as vegetables, fruits, leaves, water. We believe that vegetables have also any life form has a soul, and therefore the murder of a vegetable is not in any way different qualitatively from the murder of an animal. But the thing is that vegetables are our allotment according to scripture. We can eat certain foods that are given to us to eat by God. If we eat food that's not given to us to eat, that's robbery.
Are there any tasks that you have to perform?
Well, there's no real task. We're here to learn, and that's what we're doing. And we also we have jobs to perform to keep the organization running, to keep the word of Krishna being spread.
How do you do that?
Well, we recently purchased a couple of mimeograph machines, and that's helping our printing by word of mouth, by constantly being active.
Mm-hmm. Do you work?
Yeah, we all work.
Yeah. Is this kind of like, but you meet here every day, so.
Well, I'm devoting all my time here, so I work here all day. Money has to come in also. Some of us work regular jobs and devote most of our money here, mm-hmm. if not all.
Do you feel any different from before?
I feel very good. And closer to God.
What introduced you to this book?
A friend of mine told me about Love Celebration at Tompkins Square Park, which was last Thursday, or Thursday before last. And I knew I had been seeking a guru for a while. So Krishna sent me there, and I was there. And after meeting some of the initiates, I knew that the Swami really had to be into something. So I came the very next morning, mm-hmm. and I've been here since then.
I came here in America in September 1965. My mission is to preach the philosophy of Lord Chaitanya, chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. This transcendental vibration will cleanse the dirty things of the mind It doesn't matter what he is. This transcendental vibration is equally appealing to everyone without any question of language, nationality, creed or caste, because it is coming forth from the depth of the soul. This simple vibration can deliver the people of this age to salvation. Human life is meant for getting out of the threefold miseries of this material existence and forgetting their life's aim. They have become too much materialistic, and the result is that actually they haven't got that peace and of mind or peace of the world which they are hankering. And if they take to these chanting transcendental vibration, their mind, the darkness of the mind will be cleared, and they can clearly see their actual identity as part and parcel of the Supreme Lord or Krishna, and dovetailing their activities in that relationship, everything will be sublime.
I think how we're different from drunk people also is to realize that God is here and in my heart and all over all the time, but we're realizing this consciously. To know these things consciously, not just to accept it once and then enjoy. To know this moment to moment.
Well, I've only tried marijuana, but I've never taken anything else. You might say I was fortunate enough to have my self-realizations and other changes without drugs.
Perhaps Leary and some of the drug followers, they are functioning high on a low level, and we are functioning high, and we are functioning low on a high level.
Could you explain that?
You get that?
Could you
they're functioning high. They're this feeling. This is this sensual perception, which is extended so far. But they're enjoying the foods, and they're enjoying their incense and the colors and all these things. This anybody can do. And we are not enjoying these things, but we are functioning on this high level, on a level of God.
Well, we must consider ourselves as the gopis, so that we can love Krishna that much more, that we devote our whole lives to Krishna, and we must consider ourselves as females, you see.
But let's be careful.
Yes, yeah,
it takes many, many lifetimes of perfection to be a gopi.
Yeah.
One has to be the supremely developed, perfect in perfection to be able to lullaby as a gopi. This is the ultimate.
But the reason that one of the people mentioned before that being feminine is that when the masculine love and the feminine are love, and that you are feminine so that you can be loved by Krishna.
Well, does this have anything to do with being celibate or
this has to do with
sexual?
That the supreme being, of course, is male because he is Purusha, as they say in Sanskrit. That is, he is the origin, he is the creator. He is the seed, he plants the seed in the material universe of which we are the result. Therefore, we are the feminine.
This is not
whole material creation.
Well,
he is the supreme father. That has nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
I may be or I may not be. This has nothing to do with it.
I just came in and I was tired, and they said, "If you're tired, go to sleep. Lay down here."
You mean this is your first day?
Uh-huh.
And this is your first chanting session?
Yeah, this is the first time that I've been into it at all.
I came about the 1st of August. Ray was here a little earlier, I believe.
I came around the middle of August.
And then others, of course, have come within the last week.
Right.
But one thing which usually happens, those who come like this, they come and they just never go. Once you come, you stay.
Because the Swami has something which you are looking for.
Yeah. The first thing they did for us was give us our method of chanting, which is so powerful a method that it will work for anyone. In other words, you don't need to be the one person in a million who can really be successful in meditation yoga, where you have to spend years at that discipline without getting any place and then finally achieve it. Our method is so powerful that it will work for anyone in 2 days.
Should I bow down when I don't feel anything? Should I say these words when I don't feel anything? He says, yes, because this is a training. You see, you want to train yourself, and this is the most important, and then you'll gradually just fall right into it if you work hard at it. You must practice, and this is the main thing, and then you'll become entrapped in it.
So how about now? Do you feel silly?
Oh, excuse me?
Do you feel uncomfortable?
Oh, no. I see all this practicing and work was... It just had to be done in order to where I am now.
Anyone who chants Hare Krishna, have you got the whole chant?
That's a special evocation, just the same as we're all sitting here. But if I call Stanley, that's not the same as calling you. But if I call your name, then that shows my attention is riveted on you. So by riveting our attention on Krishna, we are able to use his name. In other words, if I meditated on the word Raymond, that wouldn't be the same at all. The word Krishna is God. The word Raymond, you know, at least in my house, the word Raymond is not.
Well, you have to concentrate on the words. You have to be sincere with the words. You have to surrender yourself to these words. And through this takes practice. It's not done in one session. This takes time. It took me maybe 4 sessions before I began to even chant. You see?
What happens when you do chant, when you're in it?
Well, that's hard to explain. I guess each person has a different reaction, but you just seem to open up. It seems as if something flies out of you. It's like a door opens. It slowly opens, so finally it's open, and then you walk into the unknown. But the unknown is beautiful. This unknown.
Well, you have every muscle of your body engaged in the exercise. You're singing, you're dancing, your mind is fully engaged in thinking about God. What more can there be? This is the full aim of any kind of yoga. It's to concentrate the energy to a point. And in this kirtan, your energy is concentrated on one point, God. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. What more could you want?
Thank you.
Krishna Kirtana Gana Natana Pano Premamritam Manidhi Dhira Dhira Jana Priyau Priyakarau Nirmasarau Pujitau Chaitanya Kripa Bharau Bhubi Bhuba Bharavahantarakam Bande Rupa Sanatana Raghajagam Sri Jiva Krishna Kirtana Gana Natana Parau Premamritam Banidhi Dhira Dhira Jana Priyau Priyakarau Nirmasarau Pujitau Nana Shastra Vichara Naika Nipuna Saddharma Sangasthapaka Lokanam Hitakarana Tribhuvane Mannam Saranyakana Nana Shastra Vichara Naika Nipuna Saddharma Sangasthapaka Lokanam Hitakarana Tribhumane Mannam Saranakara Radha Krishna Padaravinda Bhajanandina Matvalika Vande Rupa Sanatana Raghujuga Diva Gopalakam Krishna Kirtana Gana Natana Param Premamritam Banidhi Sri Chaitanya Kripa Bharau Bhuvi Bhuva Bharavahan Bande Rupa Sanatana Raghujuga Sri Jiva Gopalaka Sri Gauranga Gunanubandhana Vibhau Sadhya Samidhanita Papa-trapa-nikantana-tanamhitam Govinda-gana-amritai Sri Gauranga-gunan-vannan-vidhau Sadhyasamidhanmitam Papa-trapa-nikantana-tanamhitam Govinda Gana Amritai Anandambudhi Vartanai Kanipunau Kaivallani Svarakau Bande Rupa Sanatana Raghujugau Sri Jiva Gopalakau Krishna Kirtana Gana Natana Parau Premamritam Banidhi Hepato Namase Samannala Patishani Sadatu Chama Bhutvadina Ganesha Karunaya Kopina Kanthasitau Takvatu Namase Samannala Patishani Sadatu Chavad Bhutvadina Ganesha Kankarnaya Kopina Kanthasitam Gopi Bhavara Samrita Bhilahari Kallola Magnonmoho Bande Rupa Sanatana Raghunjaga Sridhiv Gopalaka Krishna Ketana Kanana Tana Parao Premamritam Vanidhi Krishna Ketana Kanana Tana Parao Premamritam Vanidhi Kujat Kokila Hamsa Sarasagana Kine Mayura Kule Nana Ratani Madhamula Pitapa Sri Yukta Vrindavani Radha Krishna Mahanisam Prabhajatau Jivarthadau Jogudha Vande Rupa Sanatana Raghujaga Sridiva Gopalaka Krishna Kirtana Ganana Tana Parau Premam Mritam Vanidhi Dhiradhira Janapriyam Priyakaram Nirmasaram Pujitam Sankhapurvakaramagananatibhi Karavasanikritam Nidrahar vihar kadi viditam Chattantav dinam chajam Sankhapurvakaramagananatibhi Kalavasanikritam Nidrahar vihar kadi viditam Chattantam dinam chajam Gopi bhavara samrita dilahari Kallola magnonmoho Bande Rupa Sanatana Raghujaga Sridiva Gopalaka Krishna Ketana Kanana Tana Padam Premamritam Vanidhi Krishna Ketana Kanana Tana Padam Radha Punnata Ke Kalinata Nayatire Chabansi Vate Preman Madhava Sada Se Sada Saya Grastau Pramattau Sada Radha Punnata Ke Kalinata Nayatire Chabansi Vate Preman Madhava Sada Se Sada Saya Grastau Pramattau Sada Radha Krishna Guna Smite Madhurima Nandena Mohitau Bande Rupa Sanatana Raghunaga Sridiva Gopalaka Krishna Ketana Ganana Tana Parau Dhira jana priyau priya karau Nirmasanam pujitau sushi chaitanya kripa bharo bhuvi bhuva bharavahanta rakho. Hare Rama Krishna Jato Maya Nama
Yeah. Bye. Thank you. Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
This is the sound vibration, and it is to be understood that this sound vibration is transcendental. And because it is transcendental vibration, therefore it appeals to everyone without understanding the language of the sound. This is the beauty. Even children respond to it. Thank you.
Jaya Radhe, Jaya Krishna, Jaya Vrindavan. Thank you. Naga Kanna Kan Jaya Dijapati Naga Kanna Kan Mokhita Jahara Paila Govinda Charam Jaya Jaya Dijapati Naga Kannagan Bhakita Jahara Paila Govinda Janam Sira Samannala Jaya Oradhasyam Sira Samannala Jaya Jaya Radhasyam
Thank you. Amen.